Hello everyone, my name is Amol More and welcome to our channel Solution to Blackboard. Now today one of our students has asked this question, find the range of fx equal to asinx plus bcosx. Now how to do this question? Because we know that sine x value lies between minus 1 to 1 inclusive of both, and cos x value also lies between the same minus 1 to 1. But over here there is no single trigonometric function. There are two functions, sine x and cos x. So how to deal with this question? So in order to deal with this question, we need to understand that we need to convert this expression into a single trigo expression. Now how to do that? So check out the coefficients of sine x and cos x. They are a and b. So let us make a very nice triangle. Okay, just keep observing this triangle. I'm going to do something with it. Now let us say we are multiplying and dividing this by under root a square plus b square. So inside I divided and outside I have multiplied. Okay, so as you can see, after multiplying and dividing, this expression is looking even more terrifying. But to tell you frankly, I can say a upon under root a square plus b square can be treated as cos theta, and b upon under root a square plus b square can be treated as sin theta. You will say how? Just square both of this. Cos square theta will be a square upon a square plus b square. Sin square theta will be b square upon a square plus b square. Add them. See, we are getting 1. Okay, so this is very nice. Let us make a triangle also, so that you are better understood with this. So a, b, under root a square plus b square. See, cos theta is a upon under root a square plus b square, and sin theta is b upon under root a square plus b square. Now to be specific, we call this value as r convention. Okay, so fx can be treated as, let us see, I will call this as r, and inside we have cos theta sin x plus sin theta cos x. But this is the compound angle formula. This is the compound angle formula for sin a cos b plus cos a sin b, which is nothing but sin of a plus b. Now, whatever the value of theta, sine will always lie between what? It will always lie between minus 1 to 1, inclusive of both. Now, let us multiply both sides by r. So, minus r to r sine of x plus theta up to r. We multiplied both sides by r, and inequality did not change because r is the square root of a square plus b square, which will always be positive. It is the length of the hypotenuse. Now middle expression is nothing but fx. So I can say that minus r to fx less than or equal to r. But minus r is minus of under root a square plus b square less than or equal to fx less than or equal to under root a square plus b square. So you can say the range is nothing but minus under root a square plus b square comma under root a square plus b square. So which is nothing but our r. So this is how we calculate the range of a sin x plus b cos x. Let me give you a simple example for the same. Fx is equal to 3 sin x plus 4 cos x. What will be the range? The range will be simply minus under root a square plus b square comma under root a square plus b square, which will be equal to minus 5 to 5. Very simple. So I hope you have understood this concept. Now let me make this very clear by drawing a graph. So let us understand this with the help of a graph. So this will be 3 sin x plus 4 cos x. Now let us see this graph. See, the maximum value, as you can see, is nothing but 5, y value. And the minimum value is nothing but minus 5, as you can see. So, y is equal to minus 5 to y is equal to 5 is the minimum and maximum value. So, we got the range, as you can see over here. this is the minimum value and this is the maximum value, which is our range. Hence, the range of this question is minus 5 to 5. So, we have understood the range of a sin theta plus b cos theta, which is minus under root a square plus b square, comma under root a square plus b square. Thank you for watching the video, guys. And do not forget to like, comment and share this video. And also subscribe to our channel.